गुड आफ्टरनून अदिति, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल स्टूडेंट्स. वी आर वेटिंग फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स, अदर स्टूडेंट्स टू जॉइन द सेशन, देन विल स्टार्ट. टुडे वी हैव वेरी इमिनेंट पर्सनालिटीज विद अस, एलुमनाइज विद अस. वन इज शशांक सिंह तोमर, हु इज एन एग्जीक्यूटिव असिस्टेंट टू प्रेसिडेंट इन जेके सीमेंट, एंड सेकेंड इज पीयूष पुष्किन जैन, who is an IPS officer, cracked UPSC exam. So these two personalities we have with us today. So please tell everybody to join the class, join the session, so that we can proceed further. Okay, so we are waiting the students to join the session. Thank you. Good afternoon, Samarth, Shivani, Sachin and Vaishali. Good afternoon very much.
गुड आफ्टरनून सर.
Okay, so let's start now. Good afternoon, everybody. We welcome you on behalf of JP University of Engineering Technology, Guna, Madhya Pradesh, for this induction session of Diksharam 2021. We welcome everyone and thank you for joining us for today's alumni session. We have already told in the yesterday session that there is a alumni sessions, series of alumni sessions lined up in coming 5 days. Who are going to speak about their success. They will talk about the latest trends of the industry, what is the requirement and the tips to be used in these 4 years of BTech curriculum. So without wasting time, I would like to now introduce Shashank Singh Tomar. Shashank has completed his BTech in chemical engineering in the year 2012 from JP University of Engineering Technology, Guna, Madhya Pradesh. During his campus placement, he offered a job by Infosys as an system engineer, but his desire to join the core field made him to join Wonder Cement in the same year 2012 as a GET graduate engineer trainee. There he started his journey, career journey in cement industry, where he was involved in operations as well as the optimization. Later on, he joined JKS Lakshmi Cement as an engineer, where he was talking about, he was taking care about heat and mass balance optimization cell. Thereafter, he joined JP Cement as a senior engineer, where he was handled operations optimization and ICO implementation. In the year of 2016, after 4 years of experience, he joined technical assistant, executive assistant to CEO in KJS Cement. And he's taking care of operations, optimization, and ISO implementation and documentation. Currently, he's an executive assistant or technical assistant at the level of manager to president projects in JK Cement, and looking after engineering, planning, execution of all projects throughout India as well as abroad. Overall, he has an experience of 9+ years. So in a very small duration, he has achieved so many things and is right now working in a very senior position. So I welcome Shashank Singh Tomar. Please, all of you, welcome Shashank Singh Tomar by giving big hand of the applause. Shashank, welcome. Welcome to JUT again.
Good afternoon to all respected faculty members, alumni cell, Abhishek sir and the team, and my dear freshers. I would like to thank you for giving me this opportunity to interact and share my experience with you all guys. First of all, I would like to welcome you all freshers on behalf of JUT. Welcome aboard. Hope you guys have started enjoying the next phase of your life. Trust me, this will be the one of the best phase of your life. So keeping it short, let me share my experience with you guys, how all started, how I have chosen this college, the subject and all my journey I will be sharing you. You guys can interrupt me anytime, else we can have a Q&A session at the last. See, choosing the college and subject is not an easy task. Hope you guys also face the same. Means, first of all, completing an education school level, then you decide of choosing a subject, whether I have to pursue MBBS, BTech, engineering or medical. Then once you choose engineering field, then there is a dilemma of choosing a subject. So first I will be sharing my journey, how I started and I end up with chemical engineering. Since childhood, I have seen my father working in GAIL. My father is in GAIL. I have seen the PSUs. So maybe from the childhood, I made my mind of joining a PSUs. And GAIL is one of the good companies which offers, means which has an opportunity for most of the chemical engineers. It has an opportunity, GAIL. So I started, means from my school onwards, I decided to take a subject as a chemical. So in year 2012, I came to know about with few of my father's colleagues that JP University is offering in chemical engineering and has a good placement. So I visited the college, I was really appreciated, means by the environment, the faculties the JP has. And definitely chemical engineering was one of the best I have taken the admission chemical engineering, and till date I hope chemical engineering is one of the best subjects. Means most of the industries I feel I interact with the colleagues, I came to know that they have either done a diploma in the cement technology from JB University, or they have did a BTech in chemical engineering. Most of this field you will face, means your seniors as well as your juniors colleagues will from the same profession. If they join a cement industry, you will meet at one point. So this way I have chosen chemical engineering, and my father is in GAIL, so that was my ambition to join GAIL. I have seen the facilities provided with the GAIL and etc. In 2012 I completed my chemical engineering. In the third year itself I was placed in Infosys, and I was about to join in the fourth, after completing my fourth year I was about to join Infosys, but meanwhile I tried for the core field. I tried myself off campus for the core fields. First of the core field for a chemical engineer comes up petrochemical industries. petrochemical industry, most of the industries are PSUs. Either you have to crack gate and you can join these PSUs. Second comes the fertilizers industries. That also major are the PSUs only. Third comes cement industries. Although I have given the gate exams also, I have cleared my gate, but due to the rank, not good rank, I couldn't get up in the interview session. I end up with the selection in the gate, but not in the interview session. So my idea was not to drop and just to carry my career. So in 2012, I have sent my resumes, updated CVs, and I got a call from the Vanda Cement just a month after leaving the college. I joined as a GET in Vanda Cement. There I was involved in operation as well as optimization cell. And after working in a year, basically if you work as in GET, it takes a year to get a confirmation as an engineer. But during a 9 month of my journey as in GET, I got an opportunity from JK Lakshmi as an engineer. And I was to take care about the optimization cell. I joined JK Lakshmi and I was looking after the optimization cell, heat balance, mass balance. I worked there for 1.5 years. And again, I got a chance to get it again, work with JP University. Initially, I started my graduation part from JP. Now I got the chance to work with JP in year 2014. I joined JP as a senior engineer and there I was taking care of optimization operations as well as ISO implementation. I was an internal auditor being identified by the company to look after 9001, 16,000, 50,000 ISO implementation in the plant. That was the first time when JP was having an implementation of an ISO in the company. Thereafter, there is a change in my profile. After working for 4 and 4.5 years in my core field, I thought of moving to the technical assistant field. I came to know about this field from the internet that this field helps you guys to basically connect with the senior most person of the company, second senior most of the company, where you get an experience you get a rich experience at very early stage of your life. Means I joined this means 24, you can say that I was 26 or 27 and I was working with the person who has an experience of 55 years. So how he handles the situation, how he controls his team, how he basically takes a decision. This you came to know at a very early age, being working with him, and you assist him as a technically, you assist him, you prepare PPT for him to present at the MD level, CMD levels, and preparing presentations and technical know-abouts, how we can come to a conclusions, where we can improve, how can we optimize the plants, everything you came to about. When you are close to your senior, the senior most person of the company, you know you need to deal basically everything that your boss deals with. By this, I have worked as an executive assistant for the CEO for KGS Cement for 3 years. Then currently, I joined JK Cement in year 2018 as an executive assistant to President Projects at the level of manager. And now I after the projects of JK Cement throughout India as well as abroad. This has a centralized cell of all projects. Recently, we are coming up with the project at Panna, MP. Just the work has been started. Few grinding units are yet in the pipeline to come. One is at Ujjain, one is at Allahabad. Two grinding units are in pipeline, which will be coming in the next year. And even JK Cement is expanding its clinker production as well as cement productions in couple of 3 to 4 years. We will be having more projects in Jodhpur, Jaisalmer, etc. So it has a good opportunity to learn, basically starting from the engineering. Being a chemical engineer, you know the process of clinker production, cement production, and how you can optimize the technology. Many technologies have come where you can optimize the power, increase the production with minimum cost. The cost of clinker you can bring, how you can bring the clinker cost to down, power consumption cost at the level benchmarks, basically the benchmarks of the industries. So by this means I'm currently in JK Cement, and now this is the best opportunity for I will tell you guys that being a chemical engineer, you should always be look an opportunity for PSUs as well as private sector. You have a good companies in private sector too. If you're preparing for GATE, that is best. You all have an opportunity for PSUs. But in case if you are not selected in a campus or in a government companies, still you have a platforms to perform where you can you can reach at the higher levels. And I would tell you guys that you can grab more and more knowledge about your field, whichever you choose. Basically, you guys have many subjects in the first year. At last, you will be choosing your final subject. Means you will be basically taking in one of the subjects you will be choosing, and you should have your knowledge based in your field, as much as knowledge you can in your field. That will be helpful for your future career. And I would request you all to. I was not in that part. I haven't participated in much cultural programs in colleges, but I will tell you guys, please participate in all cultural programs, dance, sports, etc. This will definitely will help you in your career. You should definitely plan your future. That doesn't mean you start preparing slowly, enjoy your college life and plan for a future. Concentrate on honing and improving upon your study habits, management skills and basic life skills. That is no issues. Even building a CV is most important. You guys will be basically in third year or fourth year preparing a CV. Basically preparing your CV is also a most important thing you guys have. I can speak only from my experience that I would advise any students to enjoy the journey. After all, isn't every day once get a chance to begin a new phase of life. Now moving means basically if you move on, you should explore the options that a college environment offers you in terms of extracurriculars. Please join the clubs, form connections as early as can, because first year is the easiest semester. You guys need to interact, you make friend, you join club, because starting the workload will probably increasing with the second year, third year, and you guys won't get a time in fourth year or third year. So first year is the best options to enter the join clubs and connections as early as you can. Finally, I would like to say, just chill and enjoy this journey. You basically experience. I would suggest you all guys that you should not ever think of a placement, that whether this college will give us a placement or not. What the subject you have chosen, go ahead, study well, go through your concert, be practical. You should have a practical knowledge, because once I entered a cement industry, I came to know that the practical knowledge is the most important knowledge. JP offers a good training session with his company, in his company. He has itself a cement plant. I'm not partially telling about just for as a chemical engineer. I am for a computer, means CS, EC, IT, every branch I am taking about. You should just go through your, means you should have a knowledge of your company, your subject, and you should go ahead with that. Lastly, I would means you guys can always connect me anytime, any doubt. It's all up to you. If you have any questions, you can surely ask me.
Thank you, Shashank. It was very wonderful. And I would rather say a direction you have given to the students. Shubham has asked that how is off-campus placements done? When should one start preparing for GATE? Do we have to prepare extra other than the college studies?
GATE preparation, basically you can start after completing your second year. GATE preparation, you can start. Basically, GATE is what you study in your first year, second year, third year. Not first year, basically the terms second year, third year and fourth year. You can start, of course, you can start studying after second year, GATE preparation. If you want to join a PSUs, you should start after second year preparing for the GATE. And regarding the off-campus placement, you should prepare a CV, what all experience you have, training sessions. Even I would emphasize you to put up your co-curricular activities in the CVs, because some of the companies also wants you to be in, means basically should be a good through with the extracurricular activities also. And you can prepare a CV, and I will take my experience. What I have did, I just uploaded in the naukri.com, and I did this in the maybe around fifth semester of my college, and just after completing sixth semester, I got a call, getting the calls. The first call was from the Sanghi Cement as well as the Wanda Cement. So I have never tried to approach any seniors or I haven't applied any source. Just naukri.com, and I got a call. So I will tell you guys to just prepare a good CV. It is a long journey for you guys. It's just first year, but So after second year, you can always start preparing for the GATE, and you can have a good CV, prepare a good CV, and upload in the Naukri portals. You will get a, definitely you will get a calls.
Okay, so Arun wants to know, sir, what your package and Bhanu.
Package, see, I will tell you in the initial phase, I will tell you my package. No, that's not an issue. But initially, if you start your career, don't go for the packages. Once an opportunity, use that as an opportunity. Don't bargain for the packages. If you are starting your career, you are anyhow, you will be as a, you will be taken as a GET only. If you are taken as a GET, it should be a decent amount that you can take your livelihood. It should be a decent amount, but don't go for the packages, because once you gain experience, it will hardly take a 1 month, means 1 year or 2 years to gain an experience. It is not an difficult to gain a, because you have already gone through your subject in 4 years, just a practical knowledge you need and a platform you need to perform. Don't go for the packages. Once you have a knowledge about your field, you can definitely, I will tell you my experience. I was a GET. I joined Wonder Cement in the year 2012. My CTC, my take home salary was 12,500. Now, in 9 years, my take home salary after all deduction is 1 lakh. And this is the journey of 9 years. I started take home from 12,000 to 1 lakh. I joined as a GET, now I'm a manager. So CTC is not a part. I started with 12,000. 12,000 hardly what you do. You cannot in 12,000. You get a room and accommodation part and meals provided by the company. But 12,000 in a bachelor, once you join the first company, you guys plan of a Goa trip or something. But 12,000 will not help you all to do. But gradually this CTC became. I have reached the CTC to take home to 1 lakh. So I would suggest not to go for the packages. Initially phase of your life should be concentrated on the experience. Once you gain experience, you will definitely receive a good result for that.
That's good, Shashank. Just I want to ask one thing, that what is the scope of other branches,
sir,
as well as the mechanical, civil, CSE, EC in the basically core industry? Let's talk about cement industry.
Okay, sir, basically I will tell you that cement industry is a growing industry. As we all know that India is a developing country, India is basically a developing country, and we have many projects in India, many projects, whether it's an infrastructure project, everything, cement infrastructure projects boost up the cement industry, demand of cement has been increased. If I'm taking an example of a cement industry, if a cement industry expands, it doesn't expand with the particularly the, he needs a chemical engineer. A complete setup of the company has been made. For example, we are now, capacity has been enhanced in our Panna plant. A new plant has been set up. We started recruiting the mechanical engineers. We have now recruiting the mechanical engineers, civil engineers, process engineers. All engineers has been recruited through means our campus placement as well as. So this is, I am the industry where I'm working, I'm telling you. So once there is an expansion of a project, it overall looks even a sustainability, environment, cell, safety. This also comes in this. There is a good opportunity for all. This is not just a chemical engineer. It is an opportunity for mechanical, civil, E&I, everything.
That's good, Shashank. And one more thing, that if the scope is good, why people, like we have seen the trend that everybody is looking after the CSE branch only, right? For looking after the IT industry. How you suggest to the student that maybe the CSE is not the limitation they should have, they should see in their career. They can go with other branches which they have the scope. So what can be the scope of other branches?
Exactly, you're correct. That means I will just bring a point here. Even when I was about to choose a subject, I was told, I was searched in Google. I have talked to my friends. I've discussed with my friend's father. That time I was in a dilemma to choose biotechnology as my subject. And I was about to search colleges in India which offers the best biotechnology and placement in biotechnology, because there is always an opportunity. We should not limit ourselves to computer science. Basically now computer science and EC, we are means every college has a seats for computer science, and there is a very I'm not disappointing you guys or I'm giving you a negative feedback, but computer science basically you have few projects and number of people are more, so there will be a tough filtration process to select you all, and there is a means you face little bit pressure in this IT sectors, but the other fields, mechanical engineering, civil engineering, as well as now the safety has been a good opportunity. Even I will tell, if you are looking for a, India is a developing country, then in case if you look for projects in India, all projects, if you find there are more opportunities for civil and mechanical and electrical instrumentation engineers than computer science. And the package that a civil, mechanical and electrical instrumentation engineer gets is more than a computer science engineer at the initial phase. When you compare initial system engineer, if you are offered a system engineer by Infosys, Accenture, etc., the package he offers and the mass bulk recruitments he does. Similarly, once you compare with the industries which offer a GET, a mechanical and GET, a civil GET, that is a good, based on my experience and my juniors have shared me this, that sir, we have a better opportunity in these subjects. Now, computer science, and basically I will not disappoint you guys that you should have not taken a computer science. The decision is always yours. The time you need to spend, the time you have to work for that. But overall, I would say that all subjects are equally, it should be treated equally, and the opportunity are equally same for all. Rather, I would say that opportunity now has been increased for the civil mechanical looking to the upcoming projects of all industries.
Okay, so one more question. They have said, like Samarth has asked, do GATE and MTech also help in CSE?
Pardon sir, GATE helps in?
CSE, see, for CSE branch, is the GATE and MTech is going to help them?
See, basically, practically what you want to do, what is your vision? First, you need to clear what you need to do. You want to do a job. You want to do a MBA or you want to do a MTech and you have to go for further studies for PhD. What exactly you have a vision? First, you need to clear a vision. See, my vision was to have a good job that I can enjoy my all means I, what all I want. I should able to purchase it and enjoy my life. But my target, I was clear about my target. So once I completed my chemical engineering, I tried for GATE for just for PSUs, to enter a PSU, not for entering a MTech. But if you are going for an MTech or MBA, you should be clear what you exactly want to. That should not be an option that, yeah, 2000 means this year I didn't got a campus placement, or even I have not got an off campus, let's go for MTech or MBA. This should not be an option that kuch nahi mila to ye kar liya. You should be clear with your goals. You should be clear in the first year itself. You will be taking a campus placement, or you will be preparing for MTech, you will be doing an MTech and then you will join. But I would prefer that it's better to go for an MBA or it's better to go for a job rather choosing MTech. Because a few of my seniors, few of my juniors, few of my colleagues have met me after this journey of experience and we are at the same level. He has done an MTech and we are at the same level. So MTech doesn't help him. Rather, I would tell you to go for an MBA from the good institute, or you have an taken rich experience and then you can pursue off campus means correspondence from MTech or a good correspondence for MBA from a good institute.
Okay. And sir, Gaurav have asked, what about the robotics branch? What is the scope of this branch in future?
Robotics, see, this is similarly like nanotechnology, biotechnology, and these few branches which has come in India in recent times of last 5 to 6 years. So initially we have less scope, but we cannot say that we will not be getting in a good opportunity. But see, you have to see your vision after 4 years. You are in the first year now, means you have to see a vision of 3 years. Basically you guys will be end up in 2024 or 25. So meanwhile, at the time of 24 and 25, we cannot say what all opportunities can come. So I would not say that robotics is not a good selection or not. You can always have a different selections of subject beings. Basically, the people are moving for CS, IT, Now, these are the major branches and people go, but you can always move to other branches. Yes, initially at now we don't have an opportunity, means we have less opportunities basically. We have to go on detailing. Sure, I'm sure that you will get better opportunities in these subjects also.
Thank you. Thank you. I think now, Shashank, you know Pushkin? Pushkin Jain, he's from your batch only, 2012 yes, pass yes. out. He's become now IPS, so he's been joining after you.
Yeah.
So maybe, yes, now there is no question. So let's wrap up the session.
Okay.
Thank you, Shashank. Thank you so yeah. much for your guidance, you, your direction. And I am sure that it will be beneficial to the students yeah. if they are going to implement it.
Yeah, thank you. Sir, freshers can always connect me. Sir, I am available at Facebook, WhatsApp, Insta, LinkedIn. Even
sure,
you can,
sure.
And thank you for making this Alumni cell
thank
and
you,
the app
sir.
To connect all of us.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, sure, sure, Shashank. We will connect you as per the requirement or any of the students. If they want any kind of queries, if they want any kind of answers, they can connect with you on the every social media. Shashank is there already. I have shared the LinkedIn profile of yours to the students, so they will connect you. Even we have the alumni portal, so you are also there as a active member in the portal, alumni portal. So students are anyhow in the coming years, they will be joining the alumni portal and they will be getting the information of yours.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, thank sir, Sashan. Thank you so much.
Bye, bye, sir. Thank you.
Now, we will be today the UPSC who was dreaming for the UPSC, who are dreaming for the students to become the IPS or IES officer. Now, we have alumni with us who is being cracked the UPSC exam recently, and he have joined as an IPS additional SP. So just I will be sharing the profile with you. So okay, so let's start with the another session. We welcome Pushkin Jain. Pushkin Jain, who have been graduated from Electronics and Communication branch in 2012, worked in SBI and cracked UPSC IPS in 2017. Recently, he's been promoted to additional SP, working in Nalbari district, Assam. Apart from education from JP, he has done master degrees in police management from Osmania University, Hyderabad in 2018-19. So he have experience of becoming an SBI officer, probationary officer in 2015-17. After that, he has selected in IPS. Then he become an assistant commandant, then subdivisional police officer. And now it is been, he has been promoted to additional SP. During his tenure, he has achieved so many things. Few of them are at the SBI, he has looking after the demonetization process and banking reforms. During the posting at Tinsukia, he has undertook the counter insurgency operations against various insurgent groups like Ulfa, DNL. And currently he's being engaging in eliminating the drug menace in Nalbari with the recovery of huge amount of narcotic substances. So I welcome Pushkin for the session. Yes, Pushkin, over to you.
Good afternoon, sir. Thank you so much for having me here. And it's a bit nostalgic for me to connecting back with the institution after such a long time. And it's a privilege for me to address all the young, newly inducted students. And first of all, I would wish everyone a warm welcome. Welcome to JP University. It's a great university, and you guys don't know how much lucky you are. I remember the college I passed out in 2012, and during 2010, the university was founded. Earlier it was JP College of Engineering and Technology. Then it became JP University of Engineering and Technology. So it has been a long journey. and I'm sure you guys will be doing very well in during your stay here. And trust me, the campus is so beautiful, and I'm very sure that as soon as you guys will be joining the classes, I guess the classes have been started.
The induction, after the induction the curriculum will start, the classes will start, and soon it will be convert into offline. So after 5-6 days the students are being calling in the campus and it is being conducting offline now.
Great. So the campus is so beautiful, the facilities are so much there, you have everything, and I guess you'll be enjoying your stay there. I remember I was in your position, I guess, in 2008. In July 2008, I came to the campus for the first time. I also underwent through this counseling procedure and all. I was also unsure about the future, what the future holds, what to do in life, what not to do in life. I'll start with some of my experiences in my JP University time. So I was also unsure, like many of us. I was not sure what to do and what to be expected from various branches. Many branches I didn't know. I just knew that I had an inclination for electronics during my school time. So that's why I opted for electronics. Then as the 4 years progressed, I was still not sure what I want to do in life. So by the end of the third year or fourth year, I started gathering a sense that maybe I'll be more suitable for some government service job or some civil service. So then from fourth year onwards, I started preparing for, started my journey towards civil service and all these things. Although I went through the placement, I was placed in Infosys and Accenture at that time, but I didn't opt for it. And right after my graduation in 2012, I started my preparation for civil services. Then after some time, I joined as State Bank of India as probationary officer, worked there for almost 2 years. During that time, I hope most of you would be remembering, there was a time of demonetization and banking reforms and all. So at that time, I was part of that team which was looking after that. Then in 2017, I was selected in civil services. Then my journey started in this field of life. So I would just say that during my college time, I was also not sure what to do, but I had very fond memories of that time, spending late nights with my friends and having night out sessions just before the exams. I remember Abhishek sir was my faculty in one of the semester, I guess in sixth or fifth semester, and the professional development course. And Atre sir, he taught us physics in first year in the introductory class. So I remember getting scolded by him many a times because I was not doing the tutorials at time. So these are the memories which you gather while you are on your during your period. So overall, I would just say, but what I would suggest, I would say that I would credit JP University for helping me decide what I'd want to do in life. Because during my whole four years of time, I was actively involved with the JP Youth Club, which is the main club which is associated with cultural activities like Freshers Party and the D-Equinox, the annual fest which we have. So I was actively involved in this JYC activities, either as a participant or as a coordinator. So over the four-year period time, I realized that I was more interested in administrative part or organized event management part of all these activities. I used to love myself, and even if I was not part of it, I used to deliberately try to become part of some club or some activity which required some sort of supervision, which included talks with faculty and coordinating with the students. I was cultural coordinator, event coordinator for cultural club for all, I guess, 3 years. In fourth year, I didn't participate because of placement on all these things. So that time I realized that I was more interested in all this stuff. So by the time my third year was starting, I was gathering up clarity in what I want to do in life. So I would say that JP helped me in the developing that vision, or at least that clarity about myself, that what I'm good at, what are my strengths and weaknesses. And slowly I started developing the required skills for it, and the knowledge required and what we have to do, and slowly the path became clearer. although at that time I remember 2010-11, there was not much of a guidance, especially in for the civil service aspirants in the college itself. But with the help of internet, I gathered some information, discussed it with a few of my batchmates, and then I developed my liking for it, and then I went with this thing. So my just few suggestions would be, I guess you guys have been that Diksha Aram program for almost a week now, and you have been addressed by to so many eminent personalities. I guess they must have told you what to do it. I would just say one thing, just do one thing during those 4 years. Be honest with yourself and be know yourself. What do you like? What do you want to do? It does not have to come in first semester, first year, second semester, second year, third semester, fourth semester. But at least
this.
I guess someone has.
Please shut down your mic, Shivani Singh. Please mute your mic. I'm so sorry, Pushkin.
Sir, it's fine. Sir. Yeah. Sir. So I would just say,
Shivani Singh, please mute. Shivani Singh. Shivani.
I guess inadvertently
she is not listening. Yes, you can continue. We'll take care of it.
Mr. Das, remove her. Mr. Das, remove Shivani from me. Remove Shivani from me.
Yeah, so I would just recommend everyone, just know yourself, because now guys, the age of the candidates would be 17-18 maximum, and the exposure which you guys have till now has been of a small house, small neighborhood, small district. Now it's the time, it's a transition period. After 4 years from now, when you will be thorough professional and entering into the workspace, at that time you should be prepared. So for that to happen, what you need to, in this transition period of 4 years, I would suggest just develop your worldview. Just develop your understanding of how things work. What are the different areas which you are good at? What are the different areas you want to work in? No area is good or bad. I won't say this thing. You have to decide it for yourself. I am no one to take decision for you. Your faculty is no one to take decision for you. Your parents are no one to take decision for you. It has to come from you. Otherwise, what happens when you go with the flow? कि सब कर रहे हैं तो मैं भी कर लेता हूँ, सब कैट के लिए फॉर्म भर रहे हैं मैं भर देता हूँ, सब प्लेसमेंट में अपीयर होके मेरे को नहीं पसंद है लेकिन फिर भी जस्ट टू बी ऑन द सेफर साइड, वो दैट हैज दैट डिसीजन शुड कम फ्रॉम योरसेल्फ कि आपको क्या करना है. डे वन से आपको कभी पता नहीं चलेगा, आपको 4 साल लगेंगे, कोई बात नहीं है, लगने चाहिए, बट कभी भी ऐसा प्रोसेस नहीं आना चाहिए कि आप You are not honest to yourself. आपको कुछ पसंद नहीं आ रहा लेकिन आप जबरदस्ती वो चीज परस्यू कर रहे हैं जस्ट बिकॉज कि वो पॉपुलर कन्वेंशन है. ऐसा नहीं करना. मतलब मे बी ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम यू विल स्टार्ट लाइकिंग समथिंग बट एक्सप्लोर दैट थिंग. आई वुड से सोशल मीडिया एंड इंटरनेट आर गुड अपॉर्चुनिटीज. योर फ्रेंड सर्कल इज अ गुड अपॉर्चुनिटी टू जस्ट सी, ऑब्जर्व, शेयर आइडियाज, एक्सपीरियंस दोज आइडियाज एंड देन टेक अ डिसीजन फॉर योर. 4 साल बाद मैं नहीं चाहूंगा कि आप लोग ये डिसीजन किसी और के कहने पे ले रहे हो या अनडिसाइडेड हो कि मुझे क्या करना है. कोई जल्दी नहीं है, 4 साल है आपके पास में. चाहे आप सीएससी में जाओ, चाहे ईसीई में जाओ, चाहे मैकेनिकल या कोई भी फील्ड. मैं पिछले सेशन आखिरी लास्ट 5 मिनट्स मैंने ज्वाइन किया था तो शशांक वाज सेइंग करेक्टली कि हर स्ट्रीम में अपॉर्चुनिटी है, चाहे मैकेनिकल हो, चाहे सिविल हो, चाहे केमिकल हो. It does not mean कि आपको कि सिविल या सीएससी या इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स में ही आपको अपॉर्चुनिटी मिली. सब जगह अपॉर्चुनिटी है. इट्स जस्ट दैट कि आपको अपना यू हैव टू यू आर यू शुड बी गुड एंड वॉट यू आर डूइंग. एंड वो गुड कब भी आएगा जब आपके अंदर आपका नॉलेज है एंड आपके पास स्किल है. और आपको भी पता है कोई भी चीज जब आप पे फोर्सिबली करी जाती है आप कभी उसमें अच्छे नहीं हो सकते। मे बी यू विल एक्सेल फॉर सम टाइम, थोड़ा पुश मिल जाएगा, लेकिन आपको सस्टेनेबल ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट के लिए ना इट हैज टू कम फ्रॉम इनसाइड, एंड वो तभी होगा जब द डिसीजन इज योर्स एंड योर्स ओनली। मतलब जो वो बोलते ना कि 18 इज एन एज कि आप कंट्री का प्राइम मिनिस्टर डिसाइड कर सकते हो, कंट्री आपको ऐसा मानती है कि नाउ यू आर फिट, कि आप मान सकते हो कि हाँ अब आप कंट्री का प्राइम मिनिस्टर डिसाइड कर सकते हो, आपको इतना आईक्यू आपका माना जाता है। 18 एंड 21 के बाद मैरिज की एज आ जाती है कि सोसाइटी डिसाइड करती है कि यार यू आर नाउ दैट एज कि आप यू कैन टेक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ सम अदर पर्सन ऑल्सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम योरसेल्फ। तो वो चीज लाने के लिए वो आपसे एक्सपेक्टेशन अब ये है एंड होनी भी चाहिए। मतलब नाउ देयर इज नथिंग फॉर यू लेफ्ट टू लर्न कि आप कहो कि मुझे नहीं पता, मैं कोई और आके मेरे पे यहाँ पे डिसीजन नहीं, अब मत करो। नाउ इज द टाइम कि अब आप देखो कि मेरे को क्या अच्छा लगता है, मैं किस में जाना चाहता हूँ, एक्सप्लोर इट। आपका अगर आपको जस्ट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे अगर आप डिसाइड कर लेते हो कि हाँ मेरे को ये अच्छा लग रहा है, गो अहेड, उसमें आप नॉलेज डेवलप करके देखो, स्किल्स डेवलप करके देखो। मे बी आपको फर्स्ट डिसीजन कभी सही नहीं होगा, हो सकता है सही हो सकता है नहीं हो, यू विल रियलाइज कि नहीं मुझे उसमें पसंद नहीं यार, मुझे कोई दूसरा करना है, देन गो अहेड, दूसरा फील्ड देखो। बट ये अपने मन
I think there is a network issue. Pushkin, hi, Pushkin, are you there? Yes, I think there is a some yeah. Connection issues.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now it's okay. Now it's okay.
Yeah. सो वॉट आई वाज सेइंग कि जस्ट बी ऑनेस्ट विथ योरसेल्फ, एंड जब आप ऑनेस्ट रहोगे आपको अपने आप विजडम या नॉलेज मिल जाएगी कि आपको क्या करना है। जब आप वो विजडम आपकी खुद की विजडम होगी, नॉलेज होगी कि हाँ मुझे ये करना है, आप वो चीज का रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी लोगे, खुद से लोगे। कोई कहता है कि सर मुझे करियर स्विच कर, अगर आप वो डिसीजन खुद के उस पर ले रहे हो, यू नो कि वॉट यू आर गुड एट एंड वॉट यू नो वॉट इज द पाथ। अगर आप किसी और के कहने पर रहोगे ना, कभी कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं आएगा, हमेशा आप दूसरे पर डिपेंडेंट रहोगे, इसलिए यू विल बी ऑलवेज अनश्योर कि जो मैं डिसीजन ले रहा हूँ वो सही है या गलत है। अगर आपका डिसीजन है आपका नॉलेज से लिया गया है, ऑनेस्ट बी ऑनेस्ट, किसी इमोशंस या किसी के जस्ट अंडर कंपल्शन के आके नहीं, ऑनेस्ट हो, ऑनेस्ट डिसीजन आपको भी पता है क्या होता है कि यू नो वॉट यू आर गुड एट एंड यू नो वॉट You'll be happy doing in your life. अगर आप किसी में भी अच्छा करोगे आप बढ़िया ही करोगे। कोई मतलब चाहे आप वॉल्ट डिज्नी का नाम ले लो, वो जो कार्टून फिल्म मेकर, बट आपको मैं बोलूँ कि आप कार्टून फिल्म मेकर बन जाओ, आप कहोगे ये कोई करियर ऑप्शन है, बट ही वॉज गुड एट एंड ही न्यू वॉट ही वॉज डूइंग एंड उन्होंने अपने पैशन से जो भी किया, एंड फिर मतलब आज आपको सबको पता है कि डिज्नी पिक्चर्स का कितना नाम है दुनिया में। तो ऐसे इन्फाइनाइट एग्जाम्पल्स है कि जो भी सक्सेसफुल पर्सनैलिटीज हुए हैं किसी भी फील्ड में, उनके साथ एक सबसे बड़ा कॉमन था कि उन्होंने कभी भी किसी के कहने पर डिसीजन नहीं लिया। उनका जो डिसीजन था उनका खुद का अपना डिसीजन था, खुद की ऑनेस्टी के साथ आया था, खुद की ईमानदारी के साथ आया था, ईमानदारी के साथ उन्होंने फिर जिम्मेदारी उठाई उसकी। वंस दे वर ऑनेस्ट विद देमसेल्फ देन दे टुक द रिस्क, जो होगा मेरे साथ होगा, नहीं होगा नहीं होगा, एंड दे हैड द करेज टू गो अहेड। कई बार सक्सेस मिलती है नहीं मिलती है, बट इफ इट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम योर एंड, आपके अंदर से कन्विक्शन है, डेफिनेटली आप सूनर और लेटर आप सक्सेसफुल होगे ही। तो 4 साल आई वुड से जो भी आपको आपको फैकल्टी आपको दे रही है, जस्ट बी डिलिजेंट इन इट, ट्राई टू डेवलप योरसेल्फ। अपना जो नो योरसेल्फ का मतलब यही है कि जब आप चारों तरफ से एक्सपीरियंस लोगे, यू विल ग्रो एज एन इंडिविजुअल। अभी आपका आइडेंटिटी आपका डिस्ट्रिक्ट आपका फैमिली आपका पेरेंट्स से है, 4 साल बाद आई
I think again the connection issues are there. He will be right back. And meanwhile, you can write the questions. so that who are the UPSC aspirants who are looking forward for to take up UPSC in future, they can write the questions. We will take up the questions at the end once the Pushkin will join the session. Okay, so meanwhile, I will request everybody to think about the vision, what both of the guests have said, and think about what you need to really do in your future, because these are the four years which has been very important for you to decide and plan, and then you can implement it by taking care of all the maybe the subjects and all. So Pushkin will join in soon. Yes, hello. yes yeah, Pushkin, yeah, yeah. Yes, you're right.
Yeah, continuously there has been some issue. Sorry for the disruption. So just I'll wrap it up. जब आप ऑनेस्टली करोगे करो पूरा चार साल अपना जस्ट ट्राई टू डेवलप योर पर्सनालिटी जो भी फील्ड में जाना है जैसे जाना है आई एम श्योर आप ऑनेस्ट रहोगे आप अच्छा ही करोगे हर फील्ड में अपॉर्चुनिटी है बशर्ते आप उसके लिए नॉलेज स्किल्स एंड एटीट्यूड अपने पास में रखो एंड वो सब आएगा जब आप कोई भी फील्ड में वॉलंटरीली एंड विलिंगली उतरोगे जब आप इतना कर लोगे आई एम वेरी श्योर यू विल बी सक्सेसफुल एंड दिस इज इट मैं ज़्यादा ज्ञान नहीं दूंगा बाकी चार साल है विश यू ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट एंड आई एम वेरी श्योर यू विल डू वेरी ग्रेट इन लाइफ थैंक यू
यस पुष्किन देयर आर सर्टेन क्वेश्चंस दे वांट टू आस्क लाइक डिड यू प्रिपेयर फॉर यूपीएससी थ्रू सेल्फ स्टडी और एनी ऑफ द कोचिंग यू हैव ऑप्टेड फॉर
या सर एक्चुअली आफ्टर माय ग्रेजुएशन आई वेंट टू दिल्ली फॉर सम टाइम I just took some classes for it for 6 months and then I came back. Then I studied on my own and afterwards it was all my self-education.
Okay, okay. So it's a mixed one. You have taken 6 months of online coaching and afterwards you have prepared yourself.
Yeah. Actually, what I was saying, during my fourth year, I realized that the guidance was not available on the internet. Mm-hmm. And at that time especially, so I decided that I should go for some time for Delhi. Then I did the classes, and then once I realized that now I have the required tools for clearing the exam, then I came back and then I self-prepared on.
Great. Shubham has asked that how and when we have to prepare for UPSC. Any of the students say they want to prepare. How they can prepare and when they can start preparing it for UPSC?
Basically, there's no ideal time for preparing the UPSC. But if your goal is clear from day one that you want to clear UPSC civil services, then you can obviously start from day one itself. I would just suggest that don't push yourself unnecessarily from the beginning itself. Start from the basics. There are some basic standard books for it. Especially the NCERT school syllabus books. Start from them. Slowly, the college provides an ample opportunity for doing that you can balance both your college work also as well as preparing for UPSC also. Yes, the NCERT books are very easy to read and just 100 pages each book is there. You can easily finish them in 2 days. And they are meant for students of class 6th and 12th. 6th, 12th. So it won't be an issue for them if anyone wants to read. I would say just a suggestion to all the persons who are, even if not preparing for UPSC, just develop a habit of newspaper reading. This is something which many people develop only when the interviews are coming for the placement purposes. I would say just there is no harm in developing a worldview about and what is going in the environment around you. So just developing a basic idea of how things work. It will help them in any field, whichever way they want to.
Mm-hmm. Pushkin, one thing I want to add, I want to update you that university recently have introduced one audit subject. The students has to clear that. That is the Indian Constitution and the traditional knowledge, which we are going to teach each and every student of with respect of whatever the branch they have. Right. So that they should know about what is the constitution, what is India, what is how the constitution has been made. And this will really help to get into like what they are preparing for the UPSC. Maybe they will have certain awareness about this.
Yeah, and this is good for every one of us. Yeah. Even if anyone wants to go into the civil the engineering side of it or the do masters or MBA, just because whatever knowledge which we have of all about the India and the society and the civics was given to us when we were in 6th or 7th standard. At that time, the aptitude of a person is very limited and you can't expect him to appreciate the nuances and the complexities. So now at the age of 17 and 18, I guess they'll be in a better position to appreciate and understand what really goes in the working of a country.
Hello, Christian.
Hello, sir.
Hello, sir.
I hope you won't be able to recognize me. I'm in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, and I hope I taught you C programming when you were in your first semester.
Yes, sir. I do remember.
Right. So it's nice to see you in a different uniform. We saw you in a JUT uniform here. Now you are in a different uniform. It's really great to see you.
The habit of being in a uniform was given by JP only.
Right. So can you share a bit like challenges of being a civil servant or being an IPS officer? Because everyone knows the person in the uniform and you know they aspire to be like that, but I personally feel that this is the one part of the coin, one side of the coin. Another side of the coin is the IPS officers or the IAS officers, they work under immense pressure. So the challenge is, if somebody is aspiring to become an IPS or IAS officer, he should be ready to face challenges. So you are on duty, so if your duty permits to share that, only those parts you can share with us.
So the challenge, I guess everyone knows about it, but the biggest challenge which I generally face during my day-to-day work is converting the knowledge which I have, especially the technical skills, to the field on the ground, because still the government setup is not that equipped with the skills which we generally you guys teach in the college curriculum. There are many things which we want to implement on the skills, but because of multiple obstacles and hurdles, and because the biggest problem is motivation of the staff with the system, the so-called system which has been going on continuously for a long time, is very resistant to change. So bringing a change, I would say, because even if someone has a vision, one has to understand that once joining the civil servant is just part of a system. It's a whole ecosystem. You are just a link in the spoke. You are just a spoke in a wheel. So just to move the wheel in a different direction, extra efforts is required on your end. So many times, for example, just introducing a basic MS Excel type of work and implementing in the Thana level, I can only say about the policing part of it, it becomes quite challenged because the staff is generally old, reluctant. There's a sense of inertia which is inherent in human nature. So, and if things are going on in a particular way, so people do tend to resist. So I guess bringing a change on your own, it becomes a bit difficult. But again, as I'm saying, if one is convinced about the change which wants to bring in the system or society, and if one is persistent to it, then definitely the change comes. For example, in my previous postings, I have initiated a few of such reforms regarding I'm talking the administrative part, the leave applications of the constables and all everything, which was not existent earlier. But because of the clarity of the thought, so ultimately that change was started in the system and it was being appreciated everywhere. So I am just saying that as the suggestion which I gave them, that if one is honest with themselves, then they'll have the required knowledge about it. And if you have the knowledge and conviction, definitely you will get success no matter the challenges or the obstacle which one faces. So that is one of the major challenges, initiating any change, dealing with different type of peoples, because everyone has their own set of beliefs. Belief and in an existing system do becomes challenging sometimes, but that is the fun of it. Doing something which is not easy to do, going out of your comfort zone, that is what life is all about.
Right. Right. Thank you, Kushkin, for letting us know about the challenges. Right. Over to you, Dr. Abhishek Chulla.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Kushkin will take one last question that Gulshan has sir. Asked that what can be the daily strategy to prepare according for the civil service exam? What can be the daily strategies with the curriculum of BTech?
First of all, I would say again that first be sure that you want to get into the civil service. First of all, make this decision of your own. It has not to be affected by what you see on YouTube and inspirational videos, which are ubiquitous everywhere. The decision has to come from your own. Everything else is just a distraction. Number one. Number two, once you are sure that you want to get into the civil services, I would say that if you are going to start your journey, start with reading. Develop that habit of, civil services examination as well as the job requires long sitting hours. So first of all, develop that habit of providing long sitting hours and dedicating yourself. I remember I used to go in libraries on the Sundays during my JP time, and I used to give a task to myself that today I'll be sitting for 3 hours, 4 hours at a stretch, taking loo breaks in between. That is a different matter. I started developing that habit first of all. I started developing the habit of newspaper reading. I started the habit of starting the NCRTs, which are the basic foundation books. Once when I was comfortable with the NCRTs, then I moved with the higher books. Then by the time my graduation got over, then I went to Delhi for my specific preparation. Nowadays, everything is available on internet. I would say no one is required to go and spend 6 months, 1 year, specifically in the Delhi or any other city for preparation of UPSC. Every guidance is available on internet. You can easily follow it. Even the most of the study materials are easily available. The books, they can be delivered to your hostel if you want. Then you can slowly and gradually start. Just, I would say, take small steps, and steps. That's it. Start with newspaper reading. Once you are comfortable with, then go with the NCRTs. Once you are comfortable and you have completed a good amount of books. In fact, I remember the NCRT books are complete in themselves to a certain extent. I remember even after going through the advanced books, I used to refer to NCRTs time and time again and again to clear my concerns. So I would say just make your foundation strong. Then first of all, make a blueprint, what you want to do, why you want to do, then start with your foundation, then add layers and building floors to your store building. You know? So then it will be easy for you. So.
Okay. Yes, I think now it's time to wrap up, Kushkin. I'm surely your information, your direction, your tips will really help the students who are going to think about the UPSC or maybe other profiles also. I'm not talking specially, you're talking about the UPSC, but yes, these directions, this experience will be very beneficial to the university, to the students as well. So on behalf of JP University of Engineering Technology, Guna, I extend a really heartily vote of thanks to you. You have really came up for this session from your busiest schedule to grace this occasion. So today we had a very good opportunity to hear your thoughts, and this will surely be going to encourage students, faculties, universities, and guide the students for future events. Thank you, Pushkin. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. My pleasure. My pleasure, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.